Hi everyone. In this video, I want to go through a quick review of what the molecular weight of a given molecular species is, and more specifically, we'll be talking about how to determine the molecular weight of a polymer and what exactly that means. So remembering back to some of our earliest chemistry classes, we are taught about the molecular weight of various atoms, which, if you remember, is typically given on the periodic table as grams per mole, which just means when you have an Avogadro's number of those atoms, we have so much weight. So, we can write that as the definition for the molecular weight of a given species is the sum of the atomic weights of all of the atoms within the polymer per mole. Since we are often dealing with very large molecules, do you think we would have a very large molecular weight or a low one? Well, since the molecular weight measures all of the atoms in one Avogadro's number of a polymer, it makes sense that our molecular weight will be huge compared to 1 mole of carbon atoms, for example. For a more practical example, think of HDPE, commonly used in a lot of food packaging applications, which has a molecular weight of 1,000 to 1,000,000, depending on the average polymer chain length of the polyethylene. And therefore, it can weigh anywhere from 1 to 100 kilograms per mole, whereas the molecular weight of water is about 18 grams per mole, which is practically nothing. So, the longer the polymer chain is, and the heavier the atoms are within the polymer chain, the larger the molecular weight of the polymer will be. This molecular weight has a large impact on many properties of the polymer, such as its tensile strength, toughness, elongation to break, which is how stretchy the polymer is, melting temperature, stress crack resistance, and many other things. So, understanding the molecular weight of the polymer you may someday be working on is very important. So a higher molecular weight polymer will be better at absorbing impacts when it's a solid and much more viscous as a liquid, whereas a lower molecular weight polymer will tend to be more stretchy and flexible in general, but much weaker. However, since polymers are not going to have the exact same chain length, we have to work with averages for polymer samples. Therefore, we need to consider a bit of statistics to more appropriately define our polymer. So imagine you have this beaker full of a polymer and you want to identify the molecular weight of the unknown species. So, we classify the molecular weight of polymers as either a number average molecular weight or a weight average molecular weight. The number average molecular weight of a polymer is the average molecular mass, so think of this as the chain length that appears most frequently in your sample. This is calculated as the total weight of the polymer samples divided by the number of polymers in your sample. Whereas the weight average molecular weight is the average polymer weight, so if you have a large number of long chains or a large number of small chains, this average will be brought larger or smaller respectively. This graph should make both concepts more clear to you. Thank you for checking out this video, and I hope it helped your understanding about how we define the molecular weight of polymers. If you enjoyed, please like and subscribe to support the channel. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.